with you my heart has spoken. Seek his face. It is your face, O Lord, that I seek. Hide not your face from me. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all, and with your spirit. With immense gratitude to those who normally go to St. Martha's this morning at 9 o'clock, we're here instead at St. Mary Magdalene, closed church, Facebook-only Mass, as I'm following the advice from the Department of Health and Social Care to shield until the 31st of March. We're offering this Mass for the people of the parish. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Have mercy on us, O Lord, for we have sinned against you. Show us, O Lord, your mercy, and grant us your salvation. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Christe eleison, Christe eleison, Kyrie A reading from the book of Genesis. God put Abraham to the test. Abraham, Abraham, he called. Here I am, he replied. Take your son, God said, your only child Isaac, whom you love, and go to the land of Moriah. There you shall offer him as a burnt offering on a mountain I will point out to you. When they arrived at the place God had pointed out to him, Abraham built an altar there and arranged the wood. Then he stretched out his hand and seized the knife to kill his son. But the angel of the Lord called to him from heaven. Abraham, Abraham, he said. I am here, he replied. Do not raise your hand against the boy, the angel said. Do not harm him, for now I know you fear God. You have not refused me your son, your only son. Then looking up, Abraham saw a ram caught by its horns in a bush. Abraham took the ram and offered it as a burnt offering in place of his son. The angel of the Lord called Abraham a second time from heaven. I swear by my own self, it is the Lord who speaks. Because you have done this, because you have not refused me your son, your only son, I will shower blessings on you. I will make your descendants as many as the stars of heaven and the grains of sand on the seashore. Your descendants shall gain possession of the gates of their enemies. All the nations of the earth shall bless themselves by your descendants as a reward for your obedience. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. I will walk in the presence of the Lord in the land of the living. I will walk in the presence of the Lord in the land of the living. I trust that even when I said, I am sorely afflicted, O precious in the eyes of the Lord is the death of his faithful. I will walk in the presence of the Lord in the land of the living. Your servant, Lord, your servant am I. You have loosened my bonds. A thanksgiving sacrifice I make. I will call on the Lord's name. I will walk in the presence of the Lord in the land of the living. My vows to the Lord I will fulfill before all his people, in the courts of the house of the Lord, in your midst, O Jerusalem. I will walk in the presence of the Lord, in the land of the living. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. With God on our side, who can be against us? Since God did not spare his own Son, but gave him up to benefit us all, we may be certain, after such a gift, that he will not refuse anything he can give. Could anyone accuse those that God has chosen? When God acquits, could anyone condemn? Could Christ Jesus? No. He not only died for us, he rose from the dead, and there at God's right hand he stands and pleads. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you, and with your spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus took with him Peter and James and John and led them up a high mountain where they could be alone by themselves. There in their presence he was transfigured. His clothes became dazzling white, whiter than any earthly bleacher could make them. Elijah appeared to them with Moses, and they were talking with Jesus. Then Peter spoke to Jesus. Rabbi, he said, it is wonderful for us to be here. So let us make three tents, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah. He did not know what to say. They were so frightened. And a cloud came, covering them in shadow, and there came a voice from the cloud. This is my son, the beloved. Listen to him. Then suddenly, when they looked round, they saw no one with them anymore, but only Jesus. As they came down the mountain, he warned them to tell no one what they had seen, until after the Son of Man had risen from the dead. They observed the warning faithfully, though among themselves they discussed what rising from the dead could mean.
The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
God is true to his promise to Abraham. Now Abraham must show his fidelity to God and be ready to give back the son he has been given. The request seems senseless, much like the suffering Abraham has already endured. But this is about never taking for granted the gifts of the Lord. It is also a sign to the world that human, especially child sacrifices, are not welcome. And this is why we must always remain pro-life. Of course, the sacrifice of Isaac is a prefigurement of the sacrament of Jesus Christ. The wood, the ram, the knife, and the altar, they become the cross, the lamb, the nails, and the Most Holy Eucharist. Abraham called the place of sacrifice the Lord provides. And in the Mass and in the sacraments, the Lord continues to provide us with all the grace we need. And clothed in this grace, we can move mountains and climb the hill of Christian duty, which of course is also the hill of Calvary. And in doing so, we will discover a new joyful perspective of life, as we're granted a vista of the garden of the resurrection. In holy baptism, which was our first personal transfiguration, we became the elect of God. And we have the promise that we will finally emerge unscathed and victorious from all the dangers and sufferings that we experience. Unfortunately, this salvation will not happen in this life. None of us are able to escape the certainty of dying. But with God on our side, not even death will be the last word in our life. Nothing can separate us from the love of God, not even our sins. That does not mean that our Father will not teach, correct, or even punish us when we stray from his ways. But just as a parent corrects their child, they still love them, although we must acknowledge that not every parent models themselves on God the Father as they ought to. God the Father so loves the world that he gives up his only Son for our salvation. Here is a sign of the call to obedience and to surrender to the will of God, which will lead to many blessings, namely right relationship with God, which is a prerequisite for eternal life. This, though, is not always easy to appreciate, and at times we will face challenges to our life, all of which would help us determine what is the most important thing in our life. Often that is relationship with God and with our neighbour. And so Jesus takes Peter, James and John up the holy mountain, so that they may see that all the sufferings of this world are nothing compared to the glory that is to be revealed. Jesus is wonderful in his humanity, but he is much more than just a role model for us. He is God. The Transfiguration shows the disciples that his obedience to the Father's will allows for his glory and majesty to be shown to us, and that we will come to share in it when we too rise from the dead. A real regeneration, our second transfiguration of our physical body on the last day. This is the profound truth of the gospel. We proclaim the death and resurrection of the Lord, the announcement of a glorious and triumphant Messiah who destroys sin and death, restores life to all who, like Abraham, hope and trust in God. instead of the Nicene Creed, especially during Lent and Eastertide, the baptismal symbol of the Roman Church, the Apostles' Creed, may be used. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at my hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all of his holy church. May this sacrifice, O Lord, we pray, cleanse us of our faults and sanctify your faithful in body and mind for the celebration of the Paschal festivities through Christ our Lord.
The Lord be with you, and with your spirit. Lift up your hearts, we lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For after he had told the disciples of his the holy mountain be manifested to them and his glory, to show even by the testimony of the law and prophets that the passion leads to the glory of the resurrection. And so with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly, Lord, and before your majesty, without every Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus Dominus Deus Sabaoth, Lenin Socelli et Terra, Gloria Tua, Hosanna in excelsis, Benedictus, qui venit in nomine Domini, Hosanna in excelsis.
You, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Richard, our Bishop, and all those who hold it to the truth and on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants, and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you the sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves, and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon and Jude, Linus, Peter, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysostomus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damien, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers and all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation, counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Mystery of faith, save us, Saviour of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation of the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, the place of refreshment, night and peace. To us also, your servants who, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Master Linus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon, through Christ our Lord, for whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen." The peace of the Lord be with you always, and with your spirit. Adios Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere non nobis. Adios Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere non nobis. Adios Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, dona nobis pace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
This is my beloved Son, with whom I am well pleased. Listen to him. Let us pray. As we receive these glorious mysteries, we make thanksgiving to you, O Lord, for allowing us while still on earth to be partakers even now of the things of heaven. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Father Rajesh will celebrate two public masses today here in St. Mary Magdalene at 11 a.m. and 6 p.m. Tomorrow, Monday, the Feast of St. David, we have the Requiem Mass at 12:30 for the repose of the soul of Paddy Pearson, such a well-known and loved parishioner here who served at this altar for many, many years. It's a real shame that I'm not allowed to celebrate that at the moment. But we welcome Father Paul Gillam, who was coming to celebrate the Mass. He's well known to us as well here in the parish, and he's going to celebrate Paddy's funeral here at 12:30. Just remember that funerals are reserved to 30 close family and friends. I'm going to say Mass in the presbytery at 10 o'clock for the Feast of St. David. I'll have my iPhone with me, so I'll live stream that at 10 a.m. And I'll also make that intention, the repose of the soul of Paddy Pearson. So if you're not going to the funeral, you'll be able to join the family in spirit via Facebook with me at 10 o'clock. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Bow down for the blessing. Bless your faithful, we pray, O Lord, with a blessing that endures forever, and keep them faithful to the gospel of your only begotten Son, so that they may always desire and at last attain that glory whose beauty he showed in his body to the amazement of his apostles. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever. Go and announce the gospel of the Lord. Thanks be to God.